It is a privilege to have you on the show this morning on Asabeafrika, the blog. We want to let you know that we are privileged this morning to meet a very important Nigerian, a very important African, a princess in our own right, and the wife of one of the most talented and gifted musicians in Africa, in Nigeria, in the person of Sir Shina Peters. Her name is Chief Mrs. Sammie Ayoka Peters. She's going to be our very delectable guest this morning on Asabeafrika blog. We're going to be talking to her on a whole lot of issues, ranging from her recent challenge and how she was able to get out of it, and her new NGO that is going to be talking about how to solve cancer-related issues and how to release a whole lot of people from the bondage of intellectual paralysis as regards to what to eat, how to live, and some other ways of life. She's just back from the United States of America after almost 2 years sojourn. But we want to tell you that she's back with a whole lot of intelligence, a whole lot of knowledge about what she's going to be doing. And in a very short while, we'll bring you the exclusive encounter with this fantastic African lady. Watch out.
The challenge was like something that came as a shock. It was a shock to me because from my language, like my mother, I had it's hereditary, understand. But later I got to know it's not all cancerous cells that are hereditary. Some just comes, you understand? Maybe it's age and it's everything that comes. So I want to shed more light on that because I want the whole Nigerians, especially women, to know. And you will be the first that I will reveal the kind of cancer that I have. Because nobody, you know, they just say cancer, but they didn't know the type of cancer that it was. It was a breast cancer. And I was like feeling funny. No much pain. Because why it kills so many people is like it's a painless thing. Until when it gets to the last stage, that is when it brings the pains. So I was like, what is wrong with me? Well, I'm feeling some kind of dull pain on my breast. So I am a kind of person that I listen to my body language. So it's always good to listen to your body language. Our body talks to us. When you have headache, don't take it lightly. That is just an headache. It will go. No. You have to go. That is why in America, they take things like, they don't take anything lightly.
Especially health.
They are not gods. They are not God, rather. Sorry. Yeah. They are not God and they are not gods. We have this idol something.
Yeah.
So they are not God. They play this role of not taking anything lightly. So I am the kind of person that I don't take my health lightly. I normally go for mammogram, like yearly something. For some reasons, I just relax. You understand? For reason, I don't know. I just relax. So this thing came and I said, okay, let me go do checkup. I didn't go to any doctor. I just went to the laboratory center straight. So they said I want to do a check on my breast.
Yeah.
And they did it. What shocked me is that this is a routine that I've been doing years back. Yeah. So this very day, normally they would tell me, I'm madam, nothing. But this very day, they didn't tell me nothing. They said, I go. Are we going to give you a call? So from there, I was like worried a bit. That what's going on here? And I told the guy, why aren't you telling me my results immediately? And they said, mommy, don't worry. We're going to call you, all these things. So I said, okay. And I left. But I was worried. Even before the test came, I knew something was wrong. Something was not right. So I waited and I was called and I went back. When I got there, they did the test again and they said they would get back to me. So they went and they came back and the guy said, we found a tumor your breast, so breast, you have to go and take care of it and all this. He just said the thing casually, as if it means nothing. I was like, what is going on? What is this man saying? So I went to my doctor of years, which I wouldn't want to mention even the name. So on getting there, you know, as a doctor, you are not an oncologist. You shouldn't have touched the breast in the first place. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yes.
So my the center, I was advised to go for biopsy, which then I didn't even know the meaning of biopsy then, which I know now the meaning of biopsy, that I should go for proper checkup, which they would just use needle to go inside the breast and they bring out the small test of the tumor to like know if the tumor was cancerous or not. Because not all breast tumor or not all tumors are cancerous. Yes, not all. So instead of saying that, he just advised me that because you are, you know, you are in your 50s and all these things, because of menopause and all those things, just try and let's remove it. And we found it early. So it was like 2 meters and something, centimeter or something. So he was telling me, and I didn't know anything. So I just went for the surgery immediately. And afterwards, I was like, the thing was not healing fast as it should. So I had to go back. But he told me after the surgery, you'll be taking the samples of the mass, the solid mass is found to like South Africa or something. So I agreed. So I now went back to him and said, Daddy, this thing is not healing up on time. What's going on? And he said, I hope there is no problem. And he said, there is problem. My heart was like pounding. Problem? What's going on? And he said, sit down, Sammy, just sit down. And my husband was in London then, and my husband was on the phone, and he said there is problem. My husband just hung up. I mean, he was scared. Just. So I sat down, what's the problem? He said, the tumor we found is cancerous, and I want you to go take care of yourself. If you go to India, if you need doctors, I can introduce you and do this. I was like, I was shocked. The initial stage, you'll be shocked, you'll be sad, I cried, many things went through my brain. I was thinking about my last born, which was Clinton, still young. My two, my first daughter and my Olumide, my second, my first son, they are grown-ups and I think they can take care of themselves. But my initial thought was like, my children, what will happen to my son? I was like devastated, I was sad, I cried, and most importantly, my partner, who I should talk to, was not around. So, and I went there, I went with my sister-in-law and my driver, so I kept my cool when I came outside. I didn't cry, I was shaking, I was like, oh, I'm dead, I was blessed, and my doctor was telling me, you are not dead, it was found early, it could be taken care of, don't worry, this. When he mentioned India, I said, no, because I don't, I've never heard of people who went through cancer and survived. We don't hear such news in Nigeria, but it's common. When I went to America and I found out, so several people that have gone through cancer and came out of it free, you get my point. So I was like, I'm dying, what is going on? Eventually we are all going to die. So later, I was like, when I got there, they did MIR, which is a machine. Yeah. They checked all over my body, my system, from my head to my toes. So they found out the cancerous cells has not spread.
Okay.
So I was like, we were all jubilating, my family. It was as if I was told I didn't even have cancer at all. Do you understand that it has not spread? It was still regional. That was the armor they used. It's still regional. Sammie, you're going to survive. Don't worry. We're going to take care of you. All these things. So I called. I said, this man, thank God. It was just then at the end of the day, I was like, thanking God that It's like God has given you the chance to reconcile with Him. If there's anything you don't know, maybe you can ask for forgiveness of sins and everything. When we are all sinners, I don't know of any particular sin that I've committed, but I just believe we are all sinners. And at that time, I was just thinking, God, have I sinned? Have I done something? But when I got to America, and I read some cancer, all these cancer things that they've written, and it was there that mostly you just believe you have done something wrong. That was why the disease came or the something came, but it's not like that. It happened. Like when I was talking to God that maybe I've seen that, maybe there's something, God forgive me, this tiny voice just came telling me, what did 5-year-old child do? Do you understand? For her to have cancer or something. Because we have children,
yes.
Like 5 years, 10 years, we are still children here, like that's really
victims.
Yes, victims of cancer, and they died eventually. You get her, some survived. You know, it was this thing that brought out the news in the first place. So I didn't tell my friends, I didn't tell my family members. Okay. It was just within the family, like myself, my husband, and my elder, like my first son, and Shade, my daughter.
Yeah.
I knew about it, but I didn't tell my dad. Like a junior, like Isaac. I call him junior. I didn't tell him because I believe he was still young. So when it came out, I thank God that my husband was in America at that time. My husband was in America. He came in on the 3rd of January. So he was with me. So the thing came out maybe January. So he was with me. I was upset initially because I didn't want anybody to know at that time. I was still going through chemo, which was a tough thing. Yes, I did chemo, I did radiation, I did surgery. I was going through a lot of things that affected my whole being, everything,
emotions,
my appearance, everything changed. So I was going through a lot of emotional distress and the chemo thing at that time, because I started my chemo December and the news came out in January. So I was so sad, I cried, and everybody, this one we call, I had this, I had that. But thank God, because my husband was around, he was able to manage it very well. And he told me, and things like this, you are my wife, you are Shina Peters, why you can't hide it from me. Just be, you know, be open about it. If you start hiding, telling them stories, they will leave you. They will eventually keep digging until the truth comes out. So it's better to just let it go. So, and that was I read Linda Ikeji's blog. They told me the name. I've never heard of it before. That was my first time, so they gave me, and I went on it, and I saw people praying, oh, not again, not this woman, not these days. So as I was reading, I was like, I was happy. At the same time, I felt loved, I was taught, and, you know, everything, all the emotions was like, I said, oh God, people love me like this.
I didn't
until the problem came. And I was just telling God, you are not going to let me die, not now. I want people to just use me as a point of contact, as a point of prayer to you. That the God that killed Sammie Peters of cancer, please kill me. So I believe that is what is going to do.
Okay.
What we eat,
yes.
The food we eat contributes a lot to our health. You understand? Either you have cancer, either it's diabetes, either it's high blood pressure, kidney problems. Mostly, like 90% of it is from like food we eat, and some are hereditary. Let me say 50-50. Some are hereditary. But even if in your family, your lineage, you have this hypertensive or something, with the food you eat, you can still correct them.
Neutralize.
Yes, you can. Because now I don't just eat anything. I've changed my diet. I don't take white sugar. I don't eat much of carbohydrates. Carbohydrate is good, but just to live. After the attack,
organic
my doc, my doctor didn't sit me down to tell me, eat this or eat that. I decided that I don't want to die now. I want to still live a little bit longer. So I went on the Google, which I like make research. Though in America, they'll give you all these nutritionists who will tell you what to eat. But I didn't just stay with the nutritionist advice alone. I went on the Google to see how can I survive, how what to eat. So what you should eat mainly is like number one, there's what we call alkaline food. What are alkaline foods? They are something natural from God. What God wants us to be eating. Anything that comes from the ground, anything that God, you know, like fruit, veggies, and it's not as if you can't eat yam, but you can eat just small yam. With like this vegetable, we dominate like the main. You make the yam your side dish or your the side food, and you make your veggies the main food. You get my point? And it's like a daily basis something. And instead of eating yam, eat like a sweet potato. When you hear sweet potato, you believe it will turn to sugar in your body. But no, sweet potato will not turn to sugar in your body. You can eat sweet potato with a veggie, like how I make my lunch at times. Like my breakfast, I take like, first thing in the morning, I take lemon or lime, like warm water. The water should not be like hot, it should be warm. So that it will not kill all the nutrients in the lemon. So you eat, you drink that, then 30 minutes later, if you want to take, you can take oats with a soya milk. You know soya milk is not milk, it's not cow milk, it's not dairy, it's like beans. You understand? So you take that one. I use the powder one since I came back. But in America we have the liquid one, which I use. Then instead of using sugar, I can put like apple. I pull all the body, the skin of the apple, because of all these chemicals they've sprayed on it. So when I after peeling, then I just got cube, then I put it in my oats. I take oatmeal in the morning with soy milk and apple as my breakfast. And at times I can take you can eat this plantain or ripe plantain with lots of vegetables. And my vegetable, you will see carrots in my vegetable. I'll use vegetable, I put carrots, I put onions, I put tomatoes, and I put hot pepper, like that we do, the small pepper, to make it spice. You know, we Africans, we love spicy food. So I take that. So something like that. And in the afternoon, I can take amala. Plantain amala, you understand? The plantain amala, I can take that with okra. Okra is fiber, it's good. Any veggie is good, you understand? Any veggie is good. So you take lots of things that grows, something, not processed food. Anything processed is called acidic food. You understand? So make it organic, fat, You understand? Rice, if you want to eat rice, you can eat our local rice like that or fada, and don't do too much of it. Red meat is a no. White sugar, brown sugar, anything sugar is a no. You understand? So your doctor, they will do their best, but the rest lies on you. Well, I'll tell my fellow women, I pray something like this will not happen to anybody. But the truth is just that today, as we are sitting, someone somewhere has just been diagnosed of cancer of something. You understand? But to talk about my own experience, what kills most Nigerian women concerning this breast cancer. It's not really the cancer, but some take it, you know, differently. Some will say, I can't cut my breast. Some will say, I don't even want to touch anything about my breast. Well, as God said, if it's one hand that will not allow you to get to the kingdom of heaven, remove it. You get what I'm saying? So it's better if you were diagnosed, don't go to just an ordinary doctor. You go straight. I don't know if they have oncologists there, but we have oncologists abroad who deals mainly just with cancer patients. Do you get my point? And any advice you were given, if you were told to like remove the breast, remove it so that your whole body may not like go. It's either you lose your whole self or you just lose the breast, and the breast is replaceable. In abroad, it's replaceable. If they cut your breast, they give you a new breast. You get what I'm saying? So then the other thing that we do in Nigeria is that you're going shaming somebody. Is an attack.
Spiritual attack.
What is spiritual attack about? You know, if you can believe whatever you like. If it's your belief that somebody somewhere is like attacking you spiritually, just make sure you go to the hospital and do the right things. You understand? If you need chemo, quickly take it. If you need to do surgery, do it. If you need to do radiation, do it. And number one thing again is for women to make sure they do their yearly screening of mammogram. It's very, very important, because that's the only way to save, you understand, to be safe if it has not spread. If it has spread, there is nothing anybody can do about it.